بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، الحمد لله. We remind each other, inshallah, for the sake of Allah, some of the words of advice from Sheikh, from the ulama. From them today, we'll look at the advice of Sheikh Rabi Hafidhullah. You can find it on his website. There are different books that are there. You can download different statements of his that are famous. From this advice is the Nasiha li Shabab, advice to the youth. And he begins by saying, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اتبع هداه. أما بعد، he says, فإني أوصي نفسي وإخواني. I advise myself and my brothers بتقوى الله, with the fear of Allah, that is in secret as well as in open, to be aware that Allah is watching us in all that we do. And in خطبة الحاجة, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, نعم, in خطبه الحاجه, the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned three verses with regards to taqwa of Allah. يا ايها الذين امنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن الا وانتم مسلمون. Oh, you who believe, fear Allah as he should be feared, and do not die except in the state of al-islam. يا ايها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحده وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والارحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. O mankind, fear your guardian Lord who created you from a single soul, and from them came many men and women. So fear Allah, from whom you demand your mutual rights, and respect the wombs that bore you. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. O you who believe, fear Allah and say a word that is directed to the truth, that he, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may forgive your sins and improve your actions. Whoever obeys Allah and the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has indeed attained a great success. So the wasiyya bi taqwallah, the advice to fear Allah, as Talq ibn Habib rahimahullah, he mentioned from the pious predecessors, he said, taqwallah is that you worship Allah upon a light from Allah, seeking his reward, and that you keep away from that which Allah has prohibited, fearing his punishment, upon a light from Allah, fearing his punishment. So advise myself, he says, and my brothers, with the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And before we enter into this topic that we're going to speak about, he says, I'd just like to advise my brothers with the salah, with the prayer, the obligatory prayers before everything. Why? Because the Shaykh Hafidhullah, na'am, he may have seen somebody neglectful of his prayers, or he may have seen somebody not praying properly. So the Shaykh subhanAllah, there and then, he wanted to advise with regards to salah. He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned, حافظوا على الصلوات والصلاة الوسطى وقوموا لله قانتين. Guard the prayers, especially the middle prayer. And the scholars of tafsir, some of them have mentioned that the middle prayer is the asr prayer. And stand up continuously with much effort in the salah. قُومُ لِلَّهِ قَانِتِينَ. Because the one who's qanit is the one who is patient, perseverant, forbearant in his ibadah. He's not just somebody who rushes his prayer and is not attentive, but he's qanit. وَقُومُ لِلَّهِ قَانِتِينَ. So in the salah, you are qanit. SubhanAllah, and this is what we have seen from the ulama, Sheikh Muhammad al-Banna rahimahullah, when he used to pray, when we used to see him pray, SubhanAllah, even in his 90s, he used to be يعني, calm in his prayer. And he would go down and he would stand in his prayer, even in his 90s. Because if you're able to stand, stand. And if you're not able due to illness or difficulty, then pray sitting. If you're not able, then on your side. So in his 90s, and he was, subhanAllah, trying his best to stand in the prayer and come down for ruku' and then go up, سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَ, and then wait until the imam goes down for the sujood. Huh? This is the sunnah that the sahaba رضي الله عنه used to wait until the imam will go down to the sujood. Not rush. And they will say the adhkar and then they will go down. Calm. And you can hear, just about hear him say, سُبْحَانَ رَبِّ الْأَعْلَى. Calm. Not like some people in the prayer, quick. Quickly. And they finish the prayer quickly. وَلَا يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. They don't remember Allah except little. This is the way of the hypocrites. يُرَاءُونَ النَّاسِ. يُرَاءُونَ النَّاسِ. They stand up to show off to the people. يعني, not to actually stand up for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's sake, but they're not, but to stand up for the people. So Shaykh Rabi'i mentioned the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Bukhari and Muslim. صَلُّوا كَمَا رَأَيْتُمُونِ أُصَلِّي. Pray as if you see me pray. I remember one time I was in his masjid praying, and subhanAllah, the Shaykh Hafidhullah, he was, I had a sutra person that was in front of me, and then he went. You know what happens sometimes? You're praying, then somebody is your sutra, and then he goes off. And from between me and the wall is so far away for me to walk. So as the Shaykh passed by and I finished my prayer, he said, Alayka bi sutra. He didn't realize that I'd really had a sutra, but look at the concern the Shaykh had. And I remember praying, mashallah tabarakah, whenever we are able to visit him in Mecca, and we were there for 3 years going to the Druze of the Shaykh, and we were to pray next to the Shaykh, putting our feet with his feet. And by Allah, and even though the Shaykh is in his 80s, he would put his ankles with your ankle. And by Allah, Shaykh Muhammad bin al-Banna, in his 90s, he would put his ankle with your ankle. Now they shabab, huh? And it's still far away, far away from praying with your Muslim brother. So Shaykh Rabi'i Hafidhullah is advising with regards to the prayer. And we've seen this with the ulama regards to the prayer. And also with Shaykh Ubayd Hafidhullah. He used to call when we lived as a neighbor to the Shaykh for 6 years. He used to call every morning for Fajr. Before Fajr, he used to call and say, meet me outside the house. Because the Shaykh is blind. Huh? And even those who spoke ill of him said that he's blind in his heart as well in his eyes. Allah, may Allah guide them for saying such a abhorrent statement. Because the Shaykh is blind, this is not his fault. He was born like that. And those who have bad tongue to say that, may Allah guide them. Because they don't know how to speak when it regards the ulama. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took away Naam, his eyesight. The Prophet said, whoever is patient upon his habibatay, yani not having his habibatay, his beloved two things, meaning his eyes, then may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, naam, that Allah has prepared for them paradise, Jannah. So if you take away your eyesight, naam, the specific hadith, that Allah will give you Jannah. So for somebody to say he is a'mal basarul basira, this is not nice. This shows you that the person himself, he himself is in need of learning the adab, the manner of how to speak with regards to ulama, with the Muslim, let alone the ulama. You don't go around saying that to a person, insulting them that they're blind in their sight. And this is something which is qadr of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he has tested a person and he is patient upon that, and you try and close your eyes for 5 minutes or 10 minutes, and how difficult it is to walk around. So don't use that as an insult. That's not nice. This is, you should say when somebody is put to trial, Alhamdulillah ladhi afana mimma btalahu bihi wa faddalana ala kathirin man khalqa tafdila. This is a trial, a test for a person. And do not use that as an insult. Huwa a'mal basar wal basira. A'udhu billah. Allah yahdi. This is not correct. This is not correct. So the Shaykh Abdullah, every morning, let's go to Quba. He used to love going to Masjid Quba. The ulama, they love the salah. حافظوا على الصلوات والصلاة الوسطى. Guard the prayers. حافظوا على الصلوات والصلاة الوسطى. Especially the middle prayer. وقوموا لله قانتين. This قانتين, والله, Subhanallah, the ulama, this is what they are upon. We've seen with our own eyes. We've seen Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah pray in front of the Kaaba, calmly moving the finger in the tashahud. I wanted to see, is he moving the finger? Yes, he's moving the finger in the tashahud. Na'am, Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah. And we prayed with Shaykh Ibn Baz rahimahullah in Riyadh. Again, calm in the prayer. Had it. You can see they love the prayer. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, جُعِلَتْ قُرَّةُ عَيْنِي فِي الصَّلَاةِ. The coolness of my eyes is in the prayer. It has been made the coolness of my in the prayer, meaning loving the salah. This love the ibadah, love the ibadah. Guarding the prayers. حافظوا على, then he said, حافظوا على النوافل. Guard the nawafil, the extra duty prayers. Not just the fard, but guard على النوافل. حافظوا على النوافل. فإنها, he says, because it is like, نعم, it is like, I can't see, it's so small writing. It says here, ish, siwar. Let's read it again. I think it says, siwar, الذي إذا هدم دخل الشيطان إلى الفرائد. It's like a, يعني, kind of barriers or pillars, or a kind of a protection, that if the protection is taken away, then shaitan will make it, it's easier for shaitan to cause destruction to the rest of your ibadah. To the rest of your ibadah. So guard the nawafil, he says. He said, even when you are traveling, when you are a musafir, of course we don't pray the rawatib, because the sunnah of Rasulullah is not to pray the rawatib, the 10 or 12 raka'as. In Bukhari it mentioned 10 raka'as, hadith of Ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma. But also, what is the correct position, Shaykh Ibn Baz rahimahullah says, that the best and most complete is 12 raka'as in the day. And that is the two sunnahs of Fajr, the four before Dhuhr. And Ibn Umar mentioned that Rasulullah ﷺ prayed two before Dhuhr, one sometimes. But what is most complete and better is the 12, the four before Dhuhr, the two after Dhuhr, the two after Maghrib, and the two after Isha, which comes to 12. So he said, of course, that is the sunnah and rawatib. We don't pray that when we're traveling. But the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, on his riding beast while he's traveling, he would pray nawafil. So it doesn't mean that there are other nawafil you can't pray. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam never left witr, for example. He never left salat al-witr, even when he's traveling. Now, and he said that I saw the statement of Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu say, لو تنفلت لأتممت. لو تنفلت لأتممت. Easy to memorize. لو تنفلت لأتممت. If you were to do the nawafil, you would actually make your salah complete or more complete. Because it may be, as in the hadith in Sunan Abi Dawood, a man prays, he gets only 1/10 of the reward. Or 1/10 of the prayer. Or 1/9 of the prayer. Or 1/8 of the prayer. Or 1/7 of the prayer. Some people don't get the whole prayer. Because their mind wanders. Because their prayer is not complete. They rushed. They missed something important. Their prayer may not be complete. Look at the man who prayed badly. He said, Salaamu Alaikum. He's giving salam to Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, after replying to salam, said, go back and pray for having not prayed. Irja fa salli fa innaka lam tu salli. You did not pray. Come back, he said, go back and pray. Come back and go back and pray. They don't know, accept this prayer. He taught him how to pray, where he mentioned the arkan of the salah, and so on. So Shaykh Rabi Abdullah, before he gives his general advice, he says, I advise the youth with regards to salah, do not miss your prayer. It may be, he says, a person may go home and pray, his intention is to pray his sunnah, but he goes home and he misses his sunnah, because it becomes heavier now, becomes harder, but it is better that you pray your sunnah prayers in the whole house, because the Rasul ﷺ said, لا تجعلوا بيوتكم قبورا. Don't make your houses as graves. And that's proof to show that in the graveyards we don't pray. And that's true proof to show that in the graveyards we don't read Quran. That's proof to show that in the graveyards, there is no prayer except for one who's missed janazah prayer, he can pray the janazah prayer. But the janazah prayer is without ruku' and sujood. So there's no ruku' and sujood in the graveyards. This is, don't make your houses as graves. So he mentioned that as an introduction. He says, because I saw some of the shabab yatasahaloon. They become neglectful of their nawafil. They become neglectful of their extra prayers. He said, the salah in the house, who sees you except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So there is more sincerity in it, that you pray your sunnah prayers in the house. As for your fard prayers, then, even the blind man who inquired about the prayer, yani if he hears the adhan, was that going to be an excuse for him not to pray in the masjid? He said, no. Fati, he said to him, Fati, come to the mosque. So he said, Nasa Allah Azza wa Jalla yuwaffiqana, that he enlightens us and you. And I wanted just to mention this important affair, such that our prayer is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he said, لِأَنَّكَ مَا تَسْجُدُ لِلَّهِ سَجْدَ إِلَّا وَيَرْفَعُكَ اللَّهُ بِهَا دَرَجَةً. Because you don't pray one sajda except that Allah raises you a level. One sajda, ya akhwan. Even you walk into the masjid, expiation of sins. You walk into the masjid, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives your sins. Even the wudu, ya akhwan. The wudu, the Prophet ﷺ mentioned, as the water leaves your fingertips, the sins being removed, the minor sins being removed. As for major sins, and that requires tawbah. So, إِذَنْ أَعِنِّي عَلَى نَفْسِكْ بِكَثْرَةِ السُّجُودِ. Help me. The Prophet said, help me over yourself with doing much sujood. Yani, if you want to benefit and you want to gain much khair in the akhirah, then aid yourself by doing much sujood. The man, he asked about entering paradise and to be with the Rasulullah ﷺ in paradise. So if you want to be with me in paradise, and you want to enter Jannah, then help me over, help yourself by doing much sujood. فَكَثْرَةُ السُّجُودُ وَالسَّجْدَةُ تَتَقَرَّبُ بِهَا إِلَى اللَّهِ. He says, so much sujood and prostration, which you seek by that getting closer to Allah, Allah will raise you many levels. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, na'am, to enlighten us, and he protects us, that we are raised many levels because of sujood and ruku' and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the Day of Judgment. Na'am. The Messenger mentioned that the fire will not touch the marks of sujood. Will not touch the marks of sujood. Shaykh Muhammad bin Hadi explained that. He's saying that the marks of sujood, when you go down for ruku', some of the scholars, he said that, they say, it means the forehead. And some of the scholars say, no, it means the marks of sujood, the prostration places. When you're in sujood, there are seven places that your bones touch the ground. And he said, some of the scholars said, they are the marks of sujood. The fire will not touch you, ya Abdullah, if you are upon sujood, inshallah, and upon ibadah, upon salah, then you will be protected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he said, the second point I wanted to talk about with regards to the youth, because the first one was the salah, to guard your prayers. The second one, he said, is about brotherhood. Is about brotherhood. Al-ukhuwa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Hujurat, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَى فَأَصْلِحُ بَيْنَ أَخَوَيْكُمْ. Indeed, the believers are brothers, so rectify between yourselves. And in the hadith of the seven categories of people under the shade that Allah creates on Yawm Al-Qiyamah, سَبْعَةٌ يُظِلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي ظِلِّهِ يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلُّهُ. Seven will be under the shade. There's no other shade except that shade that Allah creates on the Day of Judgment. And from those seven is رَجُلَان تَحَابَّا فِي اللَّهِ اشْتَمَعَا عَلَيْهِ وَافْتَرَقَ عَلَيْهِ. Two men, they met for his sake, loving each other for Allah's sake, and hating each other, hating for Allah's sake. Yani loving each other. Sorry, that's my mistake. Loving each other for Allah's sake, they met upon that, and they departed upon that. They departed upon the love of Allah. So loving each other for Allah's sake, giving gifts to each other, bringing about love between each other. Na'am, because the person is upon tawheed and sunnah. Not having ta'asub of what my shaykh said, and your shaykh said. No, the asl is
قال الله قال رسول الله قال صحابة، ليس بالتمويه. ما العلم نصبك لخلاف سفاهة بين الرسول وبين رأي فقيه. So the person who is upon قال الله قال رسول الله قال الصحابة، نعم this is the one you love. الحب في الله والبغض في الله. Love and hate for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because it may be a person is mistaken and he's not an arrogant person. He's seeking the truth. But when you bring him قال الله قال رسول الله قال الصحابة, then he accepts. نعم, he doesn't have تعصب. But you get other people who have تعصب, who are partisan to groups and parties, partisan to individuals. And Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah said, حزبية is that you place a person or a group and you make ولاء and براء over them. A person or group. So, it's all about my sheikh. It's all about my people. It's all about my city or my area. And my. It's all about my thing. Not قال الله, قال رسول الله, قال الصحابة. So having love and hate for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's sake. And ta'assub al-madmum, that is the ta'assub, which is, ta'assub, all of it is madmum. And that is dispraised. We don't have ta'assub. We have tamassuk, not ta'assub. Allah said, wa'atasimu bihablillahi jami'an wa la tafarraqu. And hold all together to the rope of Allah, and do not be divided. And then he mentioned another hadith where the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم said, وَرَجُلٌ زَارَ رَجُلًا فِي قَرْيَةٍ أُخْرَى فَأَرْصَدَ اللَّهُ عَلَى مَدْرَجَتِهِ يعني في طريقه مَلَكًا أَيْنَ تُرِيد قَالَ أُرِيدُ هَذِهِ الْقَرْيَةِ أَزُورُ أَخًا لِي قَالَ أَلَهُ عَلَيْكَ مِنَّا تُرُدُّهَا قَالَ لَا إِلَّا أَنِّي أُحِبُّهُ فِي اللَّهِ. A person goes and visits another person in another village, another area. He's going to him just for the sake of Allah. Allah will send on his journey. He will send him an angel. The Prophet sent that Allah sent this angel to this individual. He said, do you have any benefit that you're going to return to him or anything? He said, no. I just love him for the sake of Allah. قَالَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ أرسلني إليك أنه يحبك كما أحببته. Allah sent me to tell you that Allah loves you just as you love this person for his sake. He loves you. Allahu Akbar. فتحابوا في الله. So love each other for the sake of Allah. أو أهل السنة. أو أهل السنة. Love each other for the sake of Allah. وَتَزَاوَرُوا and visit each other for the sake of Allah. If this is just general between brothers, how about the ulama? Allahu Akbar. We must love them even more. We must love them even more. Of course, because they are the heads of Ahlus Sunnah. They are the heads of Ahlus Sunnah. So it is strange and it is a manhaj problem if somebody hates the ulama or he speaks ill of the ulama. This clearly shows you opposition to the manhaj as-salaf. As Abu Hatim al-Razi and Abu Zur'a al-Razi from the 3rd century, they said, عَلَامَةُ أَهْلِ الْبِدَعِ الْوَقِيعَةُ فِي أَهْلِ الْأَثَرِ. The signs of the innovators is that they revile the أَهْلُ الْأَثَرِ. Who are the أَهْلُ الْأَثَرِ? The people of narrations. Who are the people of narrations? قَالَ اللَّهِ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ قَالَ الصَّحَابَ. This is what they say in their narrations, in their adillah, in their da'wah. And we have seen that from Shaykh Rabi Hafidhullah in the past 18 years of being in Saudi, or 19 years. And we have seen that from Shaykh bin Baz rahimullah, and Shaykh bin Uthaymeen rahimullah, and Shaykh al-Albani rahimullah. We have heard it in the tapes and seen his books. قَالَ اللَّهِ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ قَالَ الصَّحَابَ. And we have seen it from the ulama of Medina living there for over 10 years, we have seen it there from the ulama of Ahl Medina. And Ahlul Makkah adra bi shi'abiha. The people of Makkah know their roads. Alaysa kadhalik? Ahlul Makkah adra bi shi'abiha. This is a saying that of the Arabs. The people of Makkah know their roads. The people of Medina know their roads. From the ulama of Medina is Shaykh Rabi' Hafidhullah. He knows his roads. He knows his roads, he knows the ulama of Medina. Sheikh bin Baz rahimullah said, as for Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadi al-Madkhali hafidhullah, then he is from the ulama of Medina. Sheikh Ahmad al-Najmi rahimullah said of him that he is min afdal al-ulama, min afdal al-ulama, from the best of the ulama. Sheikh Ahmad al-Najmi rahimullah said that. Of who? Of Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadi al-Madkhali. And as for this one, this shab, this youth, on Uloom called Siwari. He said, and he lied about Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadi, said, Muhammad bin Hadi intikhabi. Hadah Allah. Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadi intikhabi? And Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadi refuted him, saying, what is it that I call to intikhab? I don't call it to intikhab. I say it's not allowed. I say the democracy and going through voting is not allowed. Why is he lying against me? Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadi, afhamahu. He refuted him. So did this youth. And the same youth now is on Uloom speaking against Sheikh Rabi' Hafidhullah. 16 pages, all about Sheikh Rabi'. Naam. 16 pages. Speaking ill of Sheikh Rabi'. Mujasafat Sheikh Rabi'. Saying that Sheikh Rabi' even calls Sheikh Salih Fawzan munafiq. A'udhu billah. Sheikh Rabi' calls Sheikh Salih Fawzan munafiq. Sheikh Rabi' Hafidhullah said, I love these two ulama. Sheikh Fawzan and Sheikh Lahidan. And I wish I die before them because of my love for them. So what is this? What is this foolishness? And these are the ones we defend. And these are the ones they don't have love and hate for the sake of Allah. Their love and hate now has become for the sake of individuals. And this is la yajuz. Hada la yajuz. And Sheikh Ubayd hafidhahullah, who studied under Sheikh Hamad al-Ansari. Sheikh Rabi said of him, هو إمام في هذا العصر. You like it or not. You like it or not. And we don't hide. And we're not afraid to speak the truth. الحق is واضح. قل جاء الحق من ربكم فلا تكونن من الممترين. Truth has come from your Lord. So don't be from the argumentative ones. حق is حق. The علماء are known. You can't see them. You don't know them. لا يصح في أذهان شيء إذا احتاج إلى النهار دليل. The man is not saying if he needs proof to say it's daylight when the sun is shining. فَعَلَيْكَ بِالْحَدِيثِ وَأَهْلِهِ فَرَأْيُ لَيْلٌ الْحَدِيثُ نَهَارُ وَلَرَبَّمَا غَيْطَ الْفَتَى سُبُلَ الْهُدَى وَالشَّمْسُ بَازِغَةً لَهَا أَنْوَارُ. Naam, so be with the hadith and his people. Sheikh Ubayd Hafidhullah, in the past 10 years that we've been in Medina, he's gone over Lu'lu' al-Marjan, all of the ibadat. He's gone over Bulugh al-Maram, all of the ibadat. He's gone over also books of fiqh, umdatul fiqh, all of the ibadat, manhaj al-salikin, and now he's going over the mu'amalat, books of aqidah of Muhammad Wahhab rahimullah, gone over most of them, if not all, kitab al-tawheed twice in 4 years, he's gone over also aqidah al-wasatiyya, he's gone over other books of Muhammad Wahhab like shurut wa arkan wa wajibat al-salah, gone over the books of aqidah of the salaf, usul al-sunnah Imam Ahmad, more than twice, more than three times, different dawrat going around different cities and areas, reviving the books of Aqidah of the Salaf. And he's gone over in 6 sittings. Qirwani of Ibn Abi Zayd al-Qirwani. The Muqaddimah. And likewise, Sharh al-Sunnah of al-Muzani. Sharh al-Sunnah of al-Marwazi. Naam. Going over the books of the ulama. And alhamdulillah, we were able to read in his own house. Aqidah al-Wasatiyya of Sheikh Salih Fawzan. He said, bring the books, the shuru' of Sheikh Salih Fawzan. We'll read them in the house. And we did that. We would bring Sheikh bin Baz's Usul al-Thalatha and read it from cover to cover. Why? Because of his love for Sheikh bin Baz, rahimullah. And we would bring Sheikh Salih Fawzan's Aqidat al-Wasatiyya and read it from cover to cover for his love of Sheikh Salih Fawzan. Hafidhullah. Sheikh Salih Fawzan, Imam Jabal, for this Siwari to speak about the ulama like this, and the people, mashallah, yutabbilun. Yutabbilun. الشيخ ربيع حفظ الله said, لا تطبلون لهؤلاء. Don't start. تصفقون. Don't start crapping for these individuals. We should tell them that this is batil. That you speak, that you open up. As for what he has mentioned, with regard to Sheikh ربيع حفظ الله saying, that these particular individuals, whether it's Fale and some of these others who went astray, that they are more harmful upon you than the Yahud and Nasara, more harmful upon you than the Shia and so on. He said, how could you say this, O Shaykh? How can you say that they are more harmful than the Shia? How can, don't you know who the Shia are? This is what Siwari is saying on Ulum. Don't you know that they are more harmful? Sheikh Rabi' Hafidullah is upon a manhaj. Manhaj al-Salaf. If you don't know that manhaj, don't speak, ya akhi. Sheikh Rabi, when he said that, because Salafs used to say that. He never said that they are worse, he said they are more harmful. وَأَخْطَرْ بِمَعْنَىٰ أَنَّهُمْ more dangerous. Because a Shi'i is clear. He's clear making ta'an upon Sahaba. But as for this one, he's claiming to be Salafi. Huh? And he brings ta'an upon Sahaba under the name of Salafiyya. Then of course he's more harmful upon you. Imam Ahmad rahimullah, he mentioned similar to that. And other than them from great ulama. This is manhaj. أنت لا تعرف manhaj السلف. And you speak about that, and mashallah, tabarakallah, they put it out on ulum. Allah yadihim. Allah yadihim. So we call to them, turn back. Ya wallah. Turn back to the way of the salaf. As-salih. Loving and hating for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Qala Allah, qala Rasul, qala sahaba. Shaykh Rabbi, all his juhud, what he has put forward. In clarifying the path. Sheikh Ubaid Hafidhullah, Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadid going over Ma'arij al-Qubul, Manar al-Sabil, and recently in Usul Fiqh, Waraqat, and going over books in the past, Tafsir ibn Kathir, and the books of Hafidh al-Hakami. If you ever want to know the books of Hafidh al-Hakami, of course you got Sheikh Zayd from his students. But Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadid, mashallah, tabarakallah, in the past few years, or 10 years, he's gone over many of his books. Mimiya of Hafidh al-Hakami, beautiful lines of poetry about Talab al-Ilm, the adab of Talab al-Ilm. And also, al-Nasikh wal-Mansukh, in Mustalah al-Hadith, he's gone over that. And he's gone over also, he's gone over Ma'arij al-Qubul now, and he's gone over Jawhara of Hafidh al-Hakami, one of the last books that Hafidh al-Hakami has written. Rahimahullah. And the Shaykh, mashallah, we witnessed his, when he was doing Lamiyat al-Mansukh of Hafidh al-Hakami, which they said to him, Ya Shaykh, please, we have it written, but we don't know that some of the tashkils are wrong. So he said to them, okay, write it down now. And from his memory, 15, 20 minutes, all one by lines of poetry just coming out. 15 to 20 minutes, subhanAllah, Allah mubarak. And we're all correcting as he's going through. And he's going through lines of poetry, just 15 minutes. You count 15 minutes, how much? If you read one juz of Quran is about 20 minutes. Yani, just all the way through. And likewise, they asked him about Mimiyat Hafidh al-Hakami. Again, all the way through. Hifd, fahm. And it's not just about hifd. It's not just about memory. It's about understanding. Khawarij, they used to memorize. But what happened to the understanding, the fahm? Where's the proof of that? Abdurrahman al-Muljam, he memorized the whole Quran. And Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu sent him to Egypt to teach the Quran when he was still alright at that time. But afterwards, after mixing with Khawarij and being from their followers, and ended up killing Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu. Who is he? Abdurrahman ibn Muljam. Memorized the whole Quran. But fa'ayn al-fahm? Where's the understanding? Idan, this is a dangerous manhaj. Ilm bila fahm. Of fahm naqis. The Prophet ﷺ said, مَضَّرَ اللَّهُ مْرِئًا سَمِعَ مَقَالَتِي فَوَعَاهَا كَمَا أَدَّاهَا. الله أكبر. نَضَّرَ اللَّهُ مْرِئًا سَمِعَ مَقَالَتِي فَوَعَاهَا وَأَدَّاهَا كَمَا سَمِعَهَا. May Allah brighten the face of a person who heard my saying. فَوَعَاهَا. What does وَعَاهَا mean? Ibn Athir, rahimahullah, in his Gharib al-Hadith, he said, فَوَعَاهَا, it means two things. حَفِظَهَا وَفَهِمَهَا. Not just حَفِظَهَا. Some people, they go memorize, mashallah, tabarakah, حَفِظَهَا وَلَا فَهِمَهَا. وَلَمْ يَفْهَمْهَا. He didn't understand it. حَفِظَهَا وَلَمْ يَفْهَمْهَا. This is not ilm. Ilm is memorizing as well as learning, understanding. فَوَعَاهَا. And Shaykh Abdul Muhsin Hafidhullah, in his Mudakkirat, you can buy it, it's about 8-9 volumes. One of them is speaking about this hadith. نَضَّرَ اللَّهُ مْرِئًا سَمِعَ. He brings all the different wordings of this hadith, and also he mentions the same fa'idah of him, of fahm, of understanding. نظر الله امرئا. May Allah brighten the face of a person, illuminate his face. Who hears my saying? He memorizes it and he understands it. This is memorize. MashaAllah, he has ilm. La, ya akhi. Sheikh Rabi Hafizullah said, the one who memorizes and doesn't understand, he's more dangerous. He's dangerous upon you. Why? Because people think, MashaAllah, عنده علم. وهو مسكين zero. Sifr. Knowledge. And one of the great benefits we read, MashaAllah, one of the books of Aqeedah, I think it was the it was Ibn Harb al-Kirmani, that one. Al-Ijma' was another one. There was a group called Sifriya. Sifriya. The zeroers. Sifriya. Allah, this is some of the Salaf mentioned this. It's one of the books that I read recently. One of the books of Aqeedah. Just came out recently. They call themselves Sifriya. يعني Sifr fil ilm. They are zero in knowledge. Wallahi, zero in knowledge. Which are they? They actually group like that. Wallahi, it's a Sifriya. Sallallahu Salama. So, la budda min al fahm. And from the fahm is loving the ulama. You may disagree upon a fiqh matter that alim brought, is mistaken. You may disagree from another alim. That's no problem. In usul, you will find them the first to come back upon correctness. For example, when Shaykh Ubayd Hafidullah said what he said on Ka'b ibn Malik, radiallahu anh, it was quick to take it back once the brothers took it to him. And it wasn't ta'an, but rather it was opening the door to ta'an. Because why? Shaykh Rabi Hafidullah didn't say, he is. He said, if he died upon this state, he would have died misguided and misguided. If he died. We know he didn't die on that state. Shaykh Ubayd, sorry, who did I say? That's a mistake. Shaykh Ubayd, we find him that when he said that, I spoke to him personally. I said, dear Sheikh, this is what's been said. He said, I read something similar from Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah in his book. But then afterwards, brothers have spoken to him about it and he took it back. He said, I saw this statement is not befitting. And I shouldn't have said that. Because it opens the door to speaking about Sahaba. He's going over books after books in Aqeedah after books, all of them defending the Sahaba, loving the Sahaba. So of course this is not his manhaj to speak ill of Sahaba. Rather he refutes those who speak ill of Sahaba. Those who say, for example, that Sahaba did bid'ah or they introduced a new thing, ahdatha, like they say about Uthman, ahdatha Uthman, Adhan. Ahdatha Uthman, a'udhu billah. We don't say that about Sahaba. We say Sahaba radhiyallahu anhum kulluhum udul, all of them are trustworthy and they don't invent. They don't invent. And Uthman radiallahu anhu, as Shaykh Rabi explained beautifully, that Uthman radiallahu anhu himself, he had a precedence in what he did. What was the precedence? It was similar because the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam introduced the in his lifetime, the Adhan al-Awwal of Fajr, before Fajr. He introduced that. Why? So the people can get ready for the Salah and also come for the Fajr prayer. Those are far away and so on. So there was a precedents, there are similar precedents. So Uthman radiallahu anhu, when he did what he did, he did that based upon a prayer and based upon a benefit, a maslaha. We don't say he did bid'ah. He did innovation. A'udhu billah. This is incorrect. And the person who said it should make tawbah. And as for quoting that Ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma, Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu saying that he fell into bid'ah, then the statement of Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, Shaykh Rabi, showed it is da'if. That it is weak. Because one of the narrators is not even from Ahl Medina. He's not even from Ahl Medina and he made opposition to Ahl Medina. So the one who tried to refute Shaykh Rabi said, you've gone against the manhaj of the muhaddithin in this matter. Ya jahil. From the manhaj of the muhaddithin is that they look at ilal. They look at the hidden defects. And this is a hidden defect here. That this individual has opposed the whole of Ahl Medina, ulama. He's opposed them. Saying that Ibn Umar said, when all the others did not say that. And even after Uthman radiallahu anhu, we find that we have also, Ali radiallahu anhu continued that sunnah of Uthman, which is the sunnah of Khulafa al-Rashideen. Which the Rasulullah said, عليكم بسنتي وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين. And Sheikh Saleh Fawzan, when he heard this, he said his statement is bid'ah. The one who says that Uthman did bid'ah or ahdatha Uthman, he said his statement is bid'ah. His statement here is bid'ah. This is what Sheikh Saleh Fawzan hafidhullah said. And that is true. We don't say Uthman or any of the Sahaba said bid'ah. إِذَا ذُكِرَ أَصْحَابِي فَامْسِكُوا فَامْسِكُوا withhold. So we have to stand up for this, ya ikhwan. Stand up for the truth. And it's no good. This is where ta'assub comes in. It's no good saying, oh, but Sheikh Muqbil rahimullah said that as well. Sheikh Muqbil rahimullah is imam. And we met him. And we visited him in hospital in Jeddah. Sheikh Muqbil rahimullah, hafidhullah, from the great scholars. And if he was mistaken in this, we don't follow him in a mistake. Do we go around saying, look, who else made a mistake in the matter? He passed away, rahimahullah. Allah ighfir lahu. Allah ighfir lahu warhamhu. We don't look for anyone else who's made a mistake. This is against the manhaj al-salaf. Manhaj al-salaf is, قال الله, قال رسول الله, قال الصحابة. Don't say, oh, but Sheikh Muqbil said, oh, but there is us. Abu Hassan used to do this. He used to go around looking for one of the salaf who made a mistake as well. He said, but I have a salaf. Yeah, you have a salaf that's mistaken in that matter. You can't look for, it's not pick and mix and choose. Yeah, a mistake is mistake. And Ibn Umar, look what Ibn, more than 10 ulama, one of them is Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali from the Muhaddithin. He said, even if it is authentic, even if we take the statement of Ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma, then we take it in terms of language, not in terms of deen. We take it. Why? Because we try to make excuse for Uthman radiallahu anhu that he doesn't do bid'ah. And he doesn't open the door to bid'ah. Of course not. Uthman radiallahu anhu, even the angels are shy in his presence. And you want to say that he introduced bid'ah or introduced a new thing. Abadan. عليكم بسنتي وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين Uthman radiallahu anhu and Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu. Continue that. Are we saying... And unfortunately, the person who said that, it wasn't just that. Sheikh Muqbil Rahimullah didn't say exactly what you said. Sheikh Muqbil Rahimullah didn't say anyone who does it afterwards. And if he did, even if he did, and I haven't read it, because somebody may bring me a tape and say, yeah, but he did in this tape. Okay, so just to stop that, discussion or argument, even if he did, until now I don't know that he did, say that anyone afterwards that continues this adhan of Uthman, then he has no excuse, and he is mubtadi'. A'udhu billah. Ali ibn Abi Talib did that. So is he a mubtadi'? This was mentioned. And I don't know at all that Sheikh Muqbil rahimahullah said this. And if he said this, he's mistaken as well. We follow the haqq, ya akhwan. قُلْ جَاءَ الْحَقِّ وَزَهَقَ الْبَاطِلِ إِنَّ الْبَاطِلَ كَانَ زَهُوقًا. Respect whoever it is who said it from Ahlul Sunnah, and the love of the ulama remains, and the haqq is correct, and the mistake is corrected. That's it. Simple manhaj. We don't need yani to reinvent principle. Principle's already there. Loving Ahlul Sunnah, loving and hating for his sake. Uthman radiallahu anhu did not do bid'ah, nor did he introduce a new thing. Because they said, oh, he didn't say bid'ah. He said ahdatha. Even ahdatha. What is أحدثة؟ أحدثة يعني ابتدع. What is أحدثة؟ It brought something new. So don't play with words. ما قال ابتدع قال أحدثة. يا أخي, it's the same thing. Don't you read خطبة الحاجة؟ إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها. Don't you read خطبة الحاجة؟ وكل محدثة بدعة. Then what is muhdatha then? It's bid'ah. Barakallahu feek. It is not something new. We're going to add. That the sahaba add. Abadan. Sahaba do not add. They follow. They are the best of those who followed. Radiallahu anhum. They loved the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They loved that. And this is why Sheikh Rabi wrote a whole piece just on this. He said, as for the person who said what he said, yani, some might say, why are you refuting him? He's unknown. He said, because it's not the person, it's the matter is so grave. The matter is so grave to accuse a Sahabi, Khulafa al-Rashideen, of having fallen into an bid'ah, or have fallen in. Of course, they say, we don't say he's a mubtadi', but we say he did bid'ah. Ya akhi, just to say he did bid'ah is batil. Is batil. Sahaba don't do bid'ah. A'udhu billah. And Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu continuing that. Does that mean he also did bid'ah? And the Ahl Medina from the Malik and other great scholars from the Fuqaha al Medina who continued that, they also did bid'ah right until today. That means you've made ibtida' of multitudes of people because others have followed that. They are all mubtadi'ah. أخي لا بد من الورع في الكلام ولا بد من الدقة في الكلام. Sahaba radiallahu anhu did not do bid'ah. This is something that Uthman radiallahu anhu did, and it is something that the ulama qabilatha bil qabul. They accepted it with the a'imma. They've accepted it with qabul, with acceptance. And who opposed them? And who opposed them in saying that they fell into bid'ah or they fell into inventing a new thing? So Sheikh Rabi' Abdullah, in this advice, he says, عليكم بالأخوة. And from the best of the أخوة is the ulama. Loving the ulama. He said, in my time, and I heard this with my own ears to him because I gave him, or mentioned to him a book, رسائل متبادلة بين الشيخ بن باز رحمه الله والعلماء. And when I said this to him, his face changed with happiness. He says, Allahu Akbar. This book here, between Sheikh bin Baz, letters, compiled all in one book between Sheikh bin Baz rahimahullah and Sheikh Al-Albani rahimahullah, between Sheikh bin Baz and Hamoud, between Sheikh bin Baz rahimahullah and Sheikh Muhammad Al-Banna, between Sheikh bin Baz and other mashayikh, all mentioned in there. A beautiful book, thick book. Sheikh Rabbi said, you must bring me this book. And he said, it reminds me of my time where the ulama in the east and the west, and also the Salafiyun, the Tullab al-Ilm from Pakistan, from Al-Hind, from Al-Maghrib, from different areas, they will all be under one path, loving each other for Allah's sake. We did not see the splitting that we are seeing nowadays. We did not see the splitting that we see. He said, the ulama, much love with each other. And even if one or two had, they would try to rectify. Others would try to cause islah and try to, but it wasn't like this now. He said, now what we are seeing, he says, we have not seen before. SubhanAllah. And I visited him just a few days ago before I came to London. And he was concerned after he gave salam to Sheikh Ubaid and Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadi and Sheikh Abdul Bukhari. Because they're mashayikh, mashayikh. There are other mashayikh in Medina. But these ones he has regular contact with, in terms of nasiha and so on. And he knows also that they have been front line for many years, since the 90s, mashallah, tabarakallah. They have been frontline when others were not even known. They only became known in the 2000s. But in the 90s, these ulama were at the forefront. Wallah. If you were not there and you are still asleep or upon ignorance, then I'm telling you now, and ulama are telling us now, that in the 90s, they were the ones at the forefront defending the manhaj al-Salafi. Because we went to Saudi Arabia in 95. Just after the Gulf War, and the Hizbiyun at that time, they used to call the people away from the ulama. So a lot of the youth used to follow the Hizbiyun. Who was at the forefront refuting the Hizbiyun? Wallahi Akhwan. We have, alhamdulillah, Sheikh Ibn Baz rahimahullah, he was there. Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen rahimahullah. But in Medina, we had the likes of these mashayikh defending the ranks. Why did Sheikh bin Baz rahimahullah defend Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadi in that time? It's because the Hizbis were speaking against him. So he defended him. And others, so he defended him. And Sheikh Ubaid Hafidullah likewise, who used to be running the Markaz al-Da'wah in Medina. And also, who put him there under the leadership of Sheikh bin Baz rahimahullah. Under the leadership of Sheikh bin Baz rahimahullah. And having so much love with his brothers. That they were there were lectures, conferences, where they would be together. Just last year, Ya Ikhwan. Just last year. We are now 1434. Just last year you had a conference in Medina. Who turned up? Sheikh Zayd bin Hadi al-Madkhali. With who? With Sheikh Ubaid Hafidhullah. And who's in the middle? Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadi introducing it. Come from big istiraha. And Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadi, he said, I'm between Ubaid and Zayd. I'm between Ubaid and Zayd, huh? Because in the Arabic language they used to always use as examples. So I'm between Ubaid and Zayd. And both of them spoke. And Sheikh Ahmad al-Najmi rahimahullah, when he visited Medina, rahimahullah, rahmatan wasi'ah, he gave a beautiful lecture in Masjid Quba, about 6-7 years ago. Hey, wallah, all in poetry. That was a talk, Allahumma barik. All in poetry of what is the aqeedah to salaf. Sheikh Ahmad al-Najmi rahimahullah. And they gathered Sheikh Ahmad al-Najmi rahimahullah, Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadi, and Sheikh Zayd bin Hadi al-Madkhali, and Sheikh Ubaid al-Jabri, and other mashaykh of Medina gathering, for a beautiful gathering. Beautiful. And there were gatherings in Makkah, Sheikh Salih Fawzan, with Sheikh Ahmad al-Najmi, rahimahullah, and Sheikh Muqbir bin Hadi al-Wadi'i. I still have the tape. That tape now is worth, you give me whatever you give me, I won't give it to you. To listen now, ma bi mushkila. Inshallah we'll transcribe it. Sheikh Muqbir, rahimullah. Sheikh Salih Fawzan. And Sheikh Ahmad al-Najmi, rahimullah. All in one place. Love for each other. And Sheikh Rabi, hafidhullah. And at that time I remember, because Sheikh Rabi turned up at the same time as Sheikh Muhammad al-Banna, rahimullah, he was there with them as well. And Sheikh Rabi, hafidhullah, they asked him, come and give talk. Abadan. He said, no. Sheikh Muhammad al-Banna is here. He's talking, not me. And they went on the same stage together. And Sheikh Rabi didn't say a word. Why? He said, because Sheikh Muhammad is here. He was my teacher. And Sheikh Muhammad al-Banna rahmah turned around and said, I used to be your teacher and now you are my teacher. Love, Ya Ikhwan. And I've seen that love between the mashayikh. What is this? Tashattut and spitting. This is not from Ahl Sunnah way, methodology. This tafarruq is from the way of Ahl Bid'ah or from Hawa, from desires. From desires. And it's a clear error in the manhaj. And we don't fall for it. Because loving the mashayikh and what they have from the Sunnah is deen. Loving them is deen, Ya Ikhwan. As the Salaf used to say, who is the Salaf at this time? They will say Abu Hamza Sukari. Huh? Who is the Jama'ah? Abu Hamza Sukari. Because he was the Salaf. He was the Jama'ah. Meaning he was the one upon Haqq. In the time of Imam Ahmad, who was it? It was Imam Ahmad Rahimullah. And those with him. A'imma. They recognize each other. Sufyan al-Thawri Rahimullah would say, if you see somebody who's Ahl Sunnah in the East or in the West, then give salam to him. Ahl Sunnah few. So love them and be with them. Don't be with this tashattut. He said, and all of a sudden it's like you're on your own. There's nobody with you. Nobody with you except yourself. You're on your own. Dry, isolated, long-faced, miserable. Akhi, be with the haqq and be with the ulama and know the adab al-ikhtilaf. The adab al-ikhtilaf. If the scholars are in matters of fiqh, matters where there is difference that is permitted, then alhamdulillah, amr is wasi'. You bring the dalil and you follow the dalil. That is your haqq that you follow. In matters of usul, then inshallah you will find them the first to make their corrections. The first you will find them to take back their errors. But don't have this tanaffur of the ulama in the corners speaking, this one, this one, this one. Shaykh Rabi Abdullah said, what you have is only Ubaid, Ubaid, Ubaid. This is your deen? This is your da'wah? These mashayikh, they have spent 40 years giving da'wah. calling to Tawheed and Sunnah. Have some adab. Have some manners in how you address them. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this manhaj is batil. And we speak out, wallahi, for the sake of Allah. We don't insult back, because we don't want to fall to that level. Allah says, idfa' billati ahsan. فَإِذَا الَّذِي بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ عَدَاوَةٌ كَأَنَّهُ وَلِيٌّ حَمِيمٌ. We don't insult. We don't lie. We don't lie back. If people want to lie, deceive and insult, leave them to be what they want to say. But in the end, we want to follow the truth. But we want to follow it upon, with good manners, good etiquette. Because we want khair for them. Wallahi, we want khair for them. And even we reach out. Back in the days, we used to reach out. Even those who insulted us and lied about us, we used to reach out, write them emails. Come, let us discuss, no problem. قال الله قال رسول. We don't have anything to shy away from. This is deen. أنصح الشباب هذا التآخي. He says, I advise the brothers with this brotherhood. He said, SubhanAllah, at that time, a Saudi and a Yemeni and an Indian and a Pakistani and a Sindhi and an Amriki, all of them ikhwa fillah. All of them brothers for the sake of Allah. This is what we should aim for, to be brothers for the sake of Allah. Qala Allah, qala Rasulullah, qala Sahaba. We don't call to insulting. We say, person made a mistake, may Allah guide them. We hope that they turn back to the truth. We don't fall down to their level. Or his hizbi, his mubtadi is this. We don't want to go down to insulting. But we advise, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to go back to the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the understanding of the companions. Look at Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah, what he used to say. وَيَقُولُ إِذَا دُكِّرَ الْعُلَمَاءُ. Look at this. He said, إِذَا دُكِّرَ الْعُلَمَاءُ فَمَالِكْ هُوَ النَّجَمُ الثَّاقِبُ. Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah used to say this, his student, that when the scholars are mentioned, then Malik is the star. Yani, the bright star. Look at love they used to have with each other. Not this ta'asub. Not going beyond bounds and ghulu. Saying, I can clean your shoes or something all your life. It's ghulu hada. And that would not be sufficient, yani. Even if the person made tawbah, they should be stopped there and then. Not after a year or two or a few years, when things are all getting heated, then we start looking at, you know, oh, that was a mistake. These are statements of ghulu. Or if, who is there that I can seek istighatha from, except you? What is this? This is the way of Sufis. It's not the way of the Salafi. The Salafi doesn't seek istighatha except with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Istighatha is seeking help in time of hardship. This is ghulu. And we should keep away from ghulu. The Rasulullah said, إِيَّاكُمْ الْغُلُو. Be warned of falling into extremism. And the other one, he said, إِمَامُ الثَّقَلَيْنِ. The Imam of the ins and the jinn. And then he wrote lines of poetry saying, they said he's made tawbah, so alhamdulillah, we want to read his tawbah. He said, إِمَامُ الثَّقَلَيْنِ. It was a mistake, I didn't mean that. But rather I meant the Imam of ins and jinn of Yemen. Only. It's even that is wrong. I didn't mean the Imam of Thaqalayn, the Imam of ins and jinn in the whole world. I just meant Yemen. Ya akhi, even that is batil, ya akhi. Have you met all the jinn? Sheikh Saif Fawzan in a fatwa regarding isti'ana bil jinn, we know it's not allowed. And one of the reasons he gives is because you don't know who you're seeking help from. It could be a kafir jinn. So, oh, mashallah, you've met all the jinn in Yemen. You've met all of them. And how is it you know he's Muslim or kafir? So, Imam al-Thaq, we don't say these words of ghulu. And don't look for someone in the Salaf who's made the same mistake. That's wrong. But someone said it. Ya, he don't do that. That's Abu Hassan Manhaj. We say haq is haq. Batil is batil. Bas. Don't say, oh, somebody said. Batil is batil. Imam, our imam and our a'imma are the anbiya.
and those that follow them upon righteousness. So we should keep away from any words of ghulu for anyone. Even Shaykh Ubayd Habibullah, many times we hear him say, and I'm not happy that this is said of me. It would stop the person who said any words of praise, and he would say, stop, I bear witness. And the angels bear witness, and Allah before all of us is bearing witness that I'm not happy with this praise. I'm not happy with this praise. And likewise, Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah, when it was said of him, "Ya Shaykh, can I mention some lines of poetry in front of you?" He said, "Go ahead." He said, "If it wasn't for you, O Ibn Uthaymeen, if it wasn't for you, yani the khair," he said, "By Allah, I'm not happy with this. I'm not happy with this. Then the person changed it. If it wasn't for you, because he said to him, change it to Quran and Sunnah, not me. It's not me that the khair is there. If it wasn't for the Quran and Sunnah and you, stop. Don't say Ibn Uthaymeen. Stop. What is that? So any batil, even if it's written, now they say that, he wasn't paying attention. But when it's written, how about if it's written? Can you not pay attention when it's written? It's written from cover, it's in a book. And there's praise in there. Jazakallah khair. So this is wrong. Batil is batil. We don't accept it. And we say to the brothers, this is not about individuals. This is about following the truth. We don't want to fall down to any insults. We don't want to fall down to, if we made a mistake even in our naql, correct us, ma'af mushkila. Correct us. Because at the end of the day, we want to know the haqq. But from what has reached us, wallahi, this is ghulu. What has reached us, this is manhaj batil. This is incorrect. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we love the ulama. We love them and we be with them. Naam. Alhamdulillah. We've met Shaykh Muhammad al-Banna rahimahullah. When I took Shaykh Ubayd for Umrah one time, and we saw Shaykh Muhammad al-Banna rahimahullah hug Shaykh Ubayd, crying as well, tears coming down his eyes. And also at that same time was Muhammad Wahab al-Wasabi rahimahullah, and they loved each other for the sake of Allah. And he said, "You must come for dinner tonight." And we met also Shaykh Rabi going to the house of Shaykh Muhammad al-Banna rahimahullah, and Shaykh Muhammad al-Banna hugged him and he picked him up from the floor, even though he's in his 90s at that time. He picked him up from the floor. Because he said, when I was young, I used to do exercise. He was fasting when he was 20, subhanAllah, regularly. He said, I used to do exercise. I used to take them for exercise. I used to take students. He said, and the teacher would be Shaykh Al-Albani, rahimahullah, because he was my neighbor, he said. And we would go out, rihlat. Just go out to the villages and give dawah. He said, I would take them. And he would wash their clothes. Look how humble he was and how much love he had for them. He would wash their clothes. And he would be the first to wake up in the morning to make them breakfast. Allahu Akbar. Shaykh Muhammad al-Banna rahimahullah. Naam. And before he passed away, I said to him, "Ya Shaykh, there are those who are speaking ill of Shaykh Ubayd at this time." He said, "The ones who are speaking ill of Shaykh Ubayd, their knowledge has not developed. Ilmuhu lam yanduj. أو علمه غير ناضج غير ناضج." These are the exact words of the Shaykh. This is not the way. If we say a mistake is a mistake, we don't have ta'asub to Shaykh Ubayd. If we had, we wouldn't have followed the fatwa of Shaykh Rabi' Habibullah regarding the fitna, to stay away and keep away and so on. We wouldn't have done that. But at the end of the day, no ta'asub. The end of the day is love. But in fitna, you'll find people falling. Allah said, "Ala fil fitnati saqatu." And lastly, we mentioned just one beautiful narration by Ibn Battah rahimahullah from Al-Iban Al-Kubra, volume 2, page 596 Hijriyah. He says, فَإِنَّ هَذِهِ الْفِتَنْ These fitan, these trials and tribulations, وَالْأَهْوَى and desires, قَدْ فَضَحَتْ خَلْقًا كَثِيرًا It has exposed many people. وَكَشَفَتْ أَسْتَارَهُمْ And uncovered the hidden things, the hidden matters. عن أصول قبيحة from أصول, evil أصول, evil foundations that they already had. فإن أسوأ الناس لنفسه
أحفظهم لسانه, for the most protected of people to himself, and the one who is secure in this fitna is the one who guards his tongue. The one who guards his tongue. So therefore, we guard our tongue and we speak the truth. Yani, we speak the truth and we don't go beyond that. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us and guide all of us, na'am, to the haqq. We don't seek any tahazzub in this or any partisanship. We want the haqq to go forward. And we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah guides our brothers who have fallen into these errors, and that He guides them back to the truth. Because Ahlul Sunnah, they love each other for Allah's sake. And they are together for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be ibadallah, ikhwana, as brothers. Kunu ma'as sadiqeen. They are Ahlul Sunnah, the sadiqeen. We be with them, and at the heads of them, the ulama. Don't be on upon a manhaj where you're on your own, refuting all the other ulama, speaking ill of them, and who, you just you. You and a few people. That was the way of the Khawarij. They isolated themselves in a place, Harura, and they ended up speaking against the best of the people, the Sahaba radiallahu anhum. And the ulama, they are the followers of the Sahaba, followers of the Anbiya. Don't be of those who end up in this fitna, making their tongues revile the best of the people of this time. Because ulama, luhum al-ulama masmuma, as Ibn Asakir rahimullah said, the flesh of the scholars is poison. We ask Allah, يعني, it's poisonous, meaning that you will harm yourself more than you harm anyone else if you speak about them. Wallahu a'lam, wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala khayri khalqillah Muhammad, wa akhir da'wan, alhamdulillah bil alameen. And as for questions, leave it for the ulama. Ahsan. This fitna is not for me to solve, it is for the ulama. They have already solved it, and they have already spoken. Just go and read their statements. Ahsan. Khayru kalam maqal wadal. The best speech is that which is precise and to the point. What can I add? Just stick to what the mashayikh, and from them, Shaykh Rabi Hafidhullah, what he has said, and Shaykh Mughbir Rahimullah, used to love him much. Na'am. And his, Shaykh Rabi's speech is clear and to the point. We ask Allah that those who have strayed and those who have gone astray in this matter, wallahi, we only want good for them. Wallahi, we only want good for them. We ask Allah that they come back to the truth. Because that will bring about a lot of khair. That will bring about a lot of youth, inshallah, who have strayed in this matter, to come back to the truth and not have this ta'assub. We have a lot of work to do. There are Ahl Bid'ah out there, the Sufis, the Rafidah, the Ahzab. Na'am, we concentrate our reputations on them. Clarify Tawheed and Sunnah to the people. Make a whole website and your own. The main thing is the Salafis. What is this? Make a whole website. All that juhud. And your whole thing is about the ulama. Alim said this, Alim said that. Alim said this, Alim said that. That's your whole juhud. MashaAllah. Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadi once, he said, when the brother brought him two books from Kuwait. One of the person, he's writing the refutation of Sheikh Al-Albani, rahimahullah. What did Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadi say? He says, MashaAllah, we don't know you. You're someone who's majhul. The only thing we know you for is speaking against ulama or refuting the ulama. That's the only thing we know you for. So MashaAllah, Tabarakallah, you have internet. Which Sheikh Abdul Rahman Muhyiddin says, interzift. Not internet, interzift. Lots of corruption you find in there. Lots of hidden speech, hidden people writing. Interzift. He said, Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadi said, look, people hide. And they try to hide behind closed doors. But what is it they're known for? They are famous for tu'unat fil ulama. MashaAllah. That's all you're known for. You haven't even done usul thalatha. Qawa'id al-arba'a, Kitab al-Tawheed, nothing. Translation of ulama, what they've said, of khair, bring about something that Muhammad Wahab Rahman said, his students, Abdul Rahman bin Hassan, Suleiman bin Abdullah bin Muhammad Wahab Rahman, bring about what they have, the khair, the juhud. Who's doing the juhud here in this country? Who is? In terms of reviving the books of the Salaf. Man, this is what the asal is. But your asal is what? Rudud, 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 ala al-ulama. MashaAllah, tabarakallah. الحمد لله الذي عافانا مما ابتلاه به وفضلنا على كثير من خلق تفضيلا. All praise is due to Allah who has saved us from a trial he's put you to. نعم. الحمد لله ولا نخشى في الله لومة لائم. بارك الله فيكم.